In this video, we're going to talk about Sundial growers. If you're considering buying Sundial growers shares in your portfolio, then please keep watching this video until the end because it'll cover many of the factors that should be considered regarding buying, holding, or selling the shares. During the most recent trading session, the stock opened at 92.3 cents and closed at 91.3 cents. The lowest point at which it fell to has been 87 cents, and the highest point it rose to was 93 cents. Compared to the current price action, its 52-week low was 14 cents, and the 52-week high was $4. The current trading volume of Sundial Growers is 134 million shares, compared to the average volume of 233 million. The trading volume of Sundial Growers shows that the market believes that the stock should edge upward, but it's unwilling to give it the necessary push to really get beyond the current resistance. Keep in mind that there are less trades in summer, historically speaking, and that may explain why the current price action seems a bit sloppy. What this means for us is that if you believe in the potential of the stock, now may be the time to consider buying more of it. Because the low volumes means that even if the market's consensus during summer is that Sundial should have higher price, it won't necessarily be doing much at the current stage. Let's take a look at the difference between the company's market cap and the enterprise value. Basically, the market cap is the sum of the price of all shares currently traded, and the enterprise value is the value of the company's assets once all the debts are paid off. We can see that the market cap of the company is $1.7 billion, and the enterprise value is just $811 million. The difference between the EV and the market cap can mean two different things. First of all, the market is willing to pay a very significant premium over how much this company is worth using standardized valuation methods. The second thing is that a company may possess potentials that are difficult to quantify, things like ideas, disruption, and influence, as well as hype. Those things often have enough steam to carry a meme stock, but even then, it probably has its own limits. In my opinion, the market is aware of the degree by which the stock is getting speculated, and is aiming towards market participants who are more risk-tolerant and speculative with their money. Now, let's talk about the number of shares the company currently has, and the shareholder composition as of the latest data available. The total number of shares outstanding is 1.9 billion shares. Amongst the total float, insiders hold 0.64% of them. We should also look at the percentage of shares owned by institutional investors. In that case, institutional investors hold 4.91% of the total amounts outstanding. There are 267 million shares that are being shorted, which represent 14.4% of the shares traded. The shareholder structure of Sundial Growers is a typical meme stock from Reddit. Most of its shareholders are retail traders, which means that the price is meant to be influenced by which direction the wind is blowing or what is the trending topic on the internet. I believe that the low ownership by both insiders and institutionals aren't good signs, especially when it comes to the later. It's sometimes normal for insiders to be a small part of the equity, because the company may have to dilute shareholders in order to pay for its expenses. The fact that institutions are reluctant at buying the shares says a lot about the money manager's opinion about the company. Maybe they're just too reluctant and will miss the gravy train when it takes off, but the bottom line is that the company is more on the speculative side of things. From both a short-term and long-term perspective, my conclusion about the stock is actually the same, because the company isn't that old in the grand scheme of things. Sundial Growers initially grabbed a great deal of attention when it went public, but unlike the EV mania back in 2020, that interest very quickly faded away, and before long, the company went into the penny stock levels. So far, the objective reality is that the stock is not only very low, but it's also very close to its historic bottom, back to October and November 2020, from which point the stock went higher. The current price action shows an almost perfect line from October 2020 onwards, with a constant increase of higher lows, meaning that it's a matter of time before the stock goes up. Maybe not back into where it was back in 2018, but at the very least, further and further away from the penny stock levels. I personally have a position that is approximately 0.5% of my portfolio and leaving it there for about 6 to 12 months. The last element to consider would be the overall market sentiment in the financial market. The current reality is that investors and money managers are not willing to blindly follow companies to throw in their money anymore, unlike much of 2020. There are many reasons why investors are now shying away from the innovative and disruptive stocks. Some will say that they were overpriced, that they were overbought, or that they were simply relying on selling dreams instead of having solid financials. But the real answer is probably a much simpler one. At one point, some people began to lock in their profits. That created a significant crash in the price companies, in the company prices, not really because they're all bad, but just because there are more sellers than buyers. That triggered a torrent of sell-offs from February of this year to nowadays. Sometimes it happened even before that. The overall tendency at the moment is that those stocks are bottoming out, but investors are generally speaking more skeptical, and the companies with real potentials may survive. Otherwise, they will probably remain within the speculative realm. Sundial is currently a bit between both, but in the current stage of things, it remains a speculative play. So please reflect that in the position that you're willing to take. Thank you for watching. If you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel.